Blockchain technologies and cryptocurrencies have surged in popularity since their inception. Many individuals have raced to invest in cryptos, and the increased interest has prompted developers to explore different technologies. As a result, many different blockchains have emerged. There are three common types of blockchain networks: public, private, and consortium, each of which serves a particular purpose, solves a specific problem, and has its own set of features. In this video, I'll give you an overview of those three blockchain technologies that are most common. Just before I do though, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay across the latest videos from Kalkine. Okay, let's check out these three blockchain technology styles, beginning with public blockchain. This blockchain is a non-restrictive, permissionless distributed ledger technology, implying that anybody with an internet connection may join and participate in a blockchain network. Mining and trading on cryptos are the most common uses of this blockchain. The continuing operations on this blockchain may be audited, written, and read by anybody, which aids in the self-governing aspect of the blockchain. However, a public blockchain does have certain drawbacks. The primary one is its high power consumption required to keep distributed public ledgers running. Other drawbacks include the absence of total anonymity, which might compromise the network security, as well as participants' identities. Along with real contributors, there may be fraudulent members involved in harmful activities like network clogging, token stealing, and of course, hacking. Private blockchain. A private blockchain, in contrast to a public blockchain, is a permissionless-based blockchain that works in a closed network. This sort of blockchain is commonly utilized within a company where just a few people participate in a blockchain network. Hence, it's preferred by firms that wish to choose blockchain solely for internal purposes. Moreover, because the network is maintained by a single authority, a private blockchain is more centralized. Examples of private blockchains include Hyperledger Sawtooth, Hyperledger Fabric, and Corda. Consortium blockchain. A consortium blockchain is ideal for enterprises requiring private and public blockchains. In this scenario, there's far more than one central in charge or more than a single organization participating who offers access to pre-selected nodes for auditing, writing, and reading the blockchain. Moreover, it retains its decentralized structure since no single authority holds control of the system. Enterprises appear to prefer consortium blockchains because they may put selected limits when configuring the networks and regulate the activity of the various users in the required roles. So, to sum it all up, a blockchain uses peer-to-peer networks to store data across millions of servers. It's sometimes referred to as decentralized distributed ledger technology since it operates without the involvement of any third-party mediator or central authority. Additionally, a blockchain provides greater transparency and security, and that is why it is currently the most talked about technology and is seeing increased adoption. If you enjoyed this video, then please make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And of course, don't forget to press the bell icon to stay across the latest videos from Kalkine. For more information, just head across to the website, kalkinemedia.com. I'm James Preston, reporting for Kalkine.